Yeah, hello and welcome to the Ben Tablet Show, the late night show, a little bit on the late side this one. Let's get started and switch to the game view. I'm sorry for the late start, a little bit like a couple of minutes late, but I completely screwed up all the toggles, buttons, switches, whatever I have. I did it all wrong. So let's get started with some games. Okay, so let's get started. Go d4, and yeah, let me first tell you a little bit about this late starting time. Yeah, currently there are many matches going on for the BenteBlitz Cup, and it continuously all the time it collides with my normal Wednesday scheduling, and therefore, I suggested, and we are trying this out, that I'm going to do the English show, this one, on Wednesdays at 10:30, which is late, but but should not then collide with any other event. And the German show will be on Fridays at 6. Yeah, 6 in the evening, Central European time. So presumably a time where many people yeah are about to start their weekends. So this is what we're trying to do to avoid any further yeah problems with scheduling. So we've been trying this and we hope it works. Isn't he giving me a full exchange here? Rook b8, that does not work. I can just take everything here. Yeah, probably you should have taken on g2. Now I'm quite happy with the ending here. So let's see. I guess rook c1. Trying to go knight e5. I have to check one particular idea. If I play b3, he might have knight c3. This is a bit off-putting. So I try to activate this rook a3, a5, for example, is a pretty good square. Just invade. So let's go to a3. Yeah, hello to Schelling Ford. Haven't been on for quite a while, I noticed. Now, how do we do this? Maybe knight to d3. I'd like to ask one question. What about my sound? Can you give me some feedback on the sound quality? The thing is, I have changed some settings and I'd like to know if my sound is good. It should be better than before, at least if you look at the purely, if you look at my equipment that I'm using, let's say it should be better than before. Yeah, and Amadeus just resigns. Yeah, yeah, I guess it's difficult to keep the pawns. Okay, now yeah, thanks for the game, Amadeus. Let's get going here. LAF. What about identity? I have never played identity, so let's do it. Sound is very good. Yeah, I mean it should be, but I never you never know. This is the best microphone that I have, that I usually only use for my recording sessions for Chessable or other serious video products. But I never used it for the streams because I always had problems getting it to work on a reasonable output level. It was always too low, and people said, "Hey, I don't hear you." And now I changed some stuff, and I think it helped. Yeah, I saw there was a match Jan Christoph Duda against Divis. Yeah, that's a lot very lopsided. It's about the same as I would play Duda, and that probably also wouldn't end well. So what is this? This is a 3-minute game, right? I have to take this into account. No, my keep it simple D4 print book. It's not yet released. It is probably at the printer, as far as I know. They told me, let's say, about a week ago, that they would send everything to the printer, and well, there is some logistics involved. Yeah, the book is printed, as are all, as far as I know, all books by Nguyen Szesz in Poland, and they have to yeah, get this all organized. Tja, I'm going to give up. My bishop pair. I don't think this is an issue because I'm very solid here and might be able to get some pressure against the hanging pawns. I'm a little bit concerned about queen a4. Yeah, the bishop on a6. Tja, let's see what he's doing. Yeah, in case of a playing strength difference between like a regular IM and somebody who's yeah, close to world class level, it's a matter of definition, but there's the example of Duda. He's number what number in the world is he, like 15 or something like that, yeah, or 20. In this case, they are simply a player that I like is simply very significantly better in all parts of the game. This is not necessarily the case if you look at a, let's say, normal 2500 GM, because in many parts of the game, many is maybe too strong, but in some parts of the game, I would be better, or somebody like Martinez, like Divis, would be better. That can be a matter of personal training preferences. Is that non-increment? Then I'm going to win this on time. He's just so slow. That can be a matter of personal talent, interest, training regimen. So in certain parts of the game, you can definitely be competitive. I think that, for example, I mean, I can only speak for me, not so much for other players, but I know that in the opening I'm very competitive, and in some middle games positions I'm also very competitive, but in many other aspects I'm not. And this is just the case if you take somebody like Duda. He's better in every single part of the game. Yeah, maybe there could be isolated cases where I know some particular opening line better or so, but that it really is no that has no effect to the overall rating or the general scheme of things. It just be a very, very, very small window where something can happen. Or he's number 14. Okay. I did not quite know the ratings are fluctuating there. So definitely world class is very much in order. I think Duda has excellent chances of becoming an absolute top player. He's completely fearless and very aggressive. That's really good in the tiebreak match against Grishuk that I was happy to commentate here on Chess24. However, we saw that in some openings, while generally his opening prep was not really up to par. That was something that he definitely has to improve. I mean, in this isolated event, yeah, I have no particular opinion about his opening play when it comes to other events, but what I saw there was not great. He was in deep trouble with black in particular, with white not so much, but with the black pieces it was pretty awful. He had the Queen's Indians didn't work really. He had a white game, the second of the classical time control game, but he also was struggling a little bit with Rook C1 and so on. He didn't. It felt like he didn't quite knew all the subtleties. Now, Pirinos Floga here played, a rare move order in a way, going into a Tarrasch, and somehow he's doing a good job in playing this position. Tarrasch is not really something that you can recommend wholeheartedly nowadays. There are too many problem lines, but he managed to somehow get a reasonable game here. I have absolutely no advantage. I also have no problem, but I have no advantage. Yeah, that's a good one. Schelling says, dude, I made it look like he was using my opening files or his opening files. Yeah, I don't know, Schelling, maybe yours are better. It was quite surprising to see how quickly he got into trouble there. But I think this is not probably going to happen all that often, yeah, in the grand scheme of things. Okay, now I'd like to put some pressure here on f7. This is why I'm going to d7. I just recognize a bit late that I'm actually giving him the a3 pawn, and he can take it. He can definitely take it. Oh, he doesn't take it. Interesting. Okay. There's something wrong with this move? No, I don't see it. Okay, rook f8. That's not super active. Let's go a4. What is he doing here? Bishop d6, maybe. No, queen takes. Okay. Yeah. I need to try to get to the seventh rank. If I manage that, I can still put a bit of pressure in this position, but it is not anything significant. Wants to go to c3, it seems. So no, I'm not making a draw. Come on. Now, g4, trying for g5. Of course, it's extremely draw-ish, but I don't really think somebody would make a draw here with white. It's just it's still a little bit annoying here, everything. He cannot do all that much, and oh, now it gets somewhat serious. Okay, bishop d6, have to avoid this one. How is he ever moving this here now? I don't see how. Okay, king should come over. King e4, there's rook e8. Not entirely sure how I'm going to make headway here. Okay. Can go here. He can check me, but I go king d3, rook e3 if he likes, king c2, and then okay, so I managed to get the king to d3. And now what? Now what? Oh. I should have seen that move. That was silly. Ugh, come on. Focus. I don't really want to not win this game. That would be pretty awful. But how on earth do you win it? Getting e4 in also would be nice. But I don't see how. Okay. Here, bishop c1 was the issue. Okay, I can take here. I did not want to do that. Maybe he can simply not free himself. But I think. Okay, no, that is also wrong. Heck. So let's do this. Seconds. This is really an issue. He tricked me. That sucks. That really sucks. After this way the game unfolded, oh my God. I got 6 seconds. Bloody. Losing this is so awful. Okay. Yeah, thanks for the game. Pirinos Floga. I donated 50 points to you. Say thank you. Then friggin' frick. All of a sudden, this bishop is coming there. Yeah, but how do you actually win this? Yeah, I have to be a little bit precise, probably, like this. Something like this is winning. I guess now I mean, he's still tied to this and I can push all the way through. Yeah, but okay, I only had 20 seconds. I just was too lame for quite a bit. He just played much quicker than I did. Okay, so let's play the next game against Forestry. Yeah, some King's Indian. That's an interesting variation with Rook e8, and some people have played this with an idea, and some don't. We'll see. Okay, he plays it without an idea. So, yeah, okay. I can maybe elaborate a little bit later what the idea would have been. E5 is the idea here, actually. But he didn't play it. Okay, now I can go e4. There's nothing particularly wrong about it. I don't think he should have allowed e5. That's very odd, actually, getting the knight to h5. Okay, maybe knight g4 wasn't any better. I mean, that is certainly possible. I'm now threatening e6, which he stops. Unfortunately, I cannot immediately win the knight somehow. Yeah, that would be the deserved punishment. But I don't really see how. Let's go. He wants to play bishop f5. Maybe I should actually do this. Yeah. Why not? I mean, he cannot move the knight. I just take a7. Okay. And back. You can get back e5, but that is, I think I'm happy to give up that one. To get his, yeah, this dark squared bishop. Okay, so queen d2 and probably rook d8. No, then I've got bishop b6. Not even that works. I had to cover the knight as well, so queen d2 is fairly natural. Yeah, it's difficult. What is he doing with this bishop on d7? Yeah, even knight a4 comes into consideration here. Just looking at bishop b6 and knight b6. Bishop b6. Okay. Yeah, so let's centralize. Maybe step out of this file. Again, queen b6. Yeah, let's go queen b6. Okay, so I can just trade everything. Okay, so knight here. Let's go b4. Get the pawns going. No, no activity, please. And now b7 should drop. Wow. Yeah, let's come closer. Yeah, and forestry resigns. That was a bit of an opening disaster, really. Thanks for the game, forestry. You should never allow e5. That was the issue here. I'm happy to get more challenges. I only got a couple. Okay, it's late, but the viewer count is not too bad. So maybe some more people willing to play. So we got C3, the C3 Sicilian or the Alapin. Wow, that is very unambitious. Got an IQP to play against and better development after 7 moves. Yeah. Okay, so this is not winning a pawn. Yeah, I don't know. Everything looks good here, actually. Knight b6, maybe bishop b5. Yeah, that still keeps his pawn. Maybe this one. I don't know. It looks pretty good already. Okay. Wow. I really like this position. I just have a great anti-IQP position after 12 moves. I've got excellent control over d5 and white has zero activity. I mean, zero. Best would be to castle kingside and then triple against the pawn. This even looks feasible. There are already quite a number of minor pieces traded. Yeah, without a light squared bishop, such an IQP position is usually just not really good. Maybe I should have moved the queen for rook d5, actually, now that I think of it. Like queen a5, rook d5, rook d8, something like that. Okay, I'm... Oh, I found a good move. I mean, it's not earth-shattering, but I did not want to play rook c7 here. But now thinking of it, it's probably not too bad. Rook c8. Queen d2 is completely mysterious to me. He just wants to leave the C file? Or? I don't know. It always looks okay because he has almost no possibility to drive my queen away from d5, and that is such a strong outpost. Now threatening rook to c2, invasion time. Rook c1, I wonder. I can simply take everything and take a2. There's really not much, nothing much wrong with that. I don't see why not. You can check me, I have bishop f8 though. And next move is almost invariably queen d5, consolidating everything and then converting the pawn. So is he going for, okay, let's do this. If he checks me, bishop f8, I don't see how he's coming around to use the pin. That would be the only idea. Bishop d2, I thought queen c6 would help. Do we only have sound like left hand side, right hand side, something like that? I don't know. It should not be, but I've changed some sound settings, so it's not impossible that something is slightly off. The right channel volume is low. Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure what to do about it. Just the right channel? Odd. I think he has weakened his own position mostly with this action. Okay, let's go here. Queen trade would be okay. Oh, he did trade queens. D5 only. Oh, D5 I thought was the only move. Now I'm getting, how do we play? How do we play? I think this first, yeah. Now I'm preventing b3 and then a5, a4, a3. Should do it. No. The sacrifice on f6 is what I thought about, but I can still stop him. Yeah, thanks for the game, Dragon Horus, or Dragon Horus, we don't know. So, Atlanta Gambit or Schelling Ford? Schelling, hang on, I'm going to take this later. Audio is coming in from the left side. Wow. I got no idea what's going on there. Let me check. Maybe I can do something here. Audio. Audio preview. Volume. No. I don't see anything there. Sorry. Have to do this when I'm not streaming, then I can try to fix it. So So there was a question by Flores. How did I push to become 2000 Elo? Mainly studying more openings or just everything a little better? Well, that is a long time ago, really a long time ago, and therefore at the time we simply had some different just conditions were different, like to today. We did not have, for example, there was no online chess, of course, that was pre-internet. So I couldn't play online games. I was playing however everything that I could, so I tried to play a lot. What I also did back then, I studied many complete games, lots of complete games by players that I liked. And how do we play this? By players that I liked, lots of Karpov games back in the day, and Kramnik probably not. Kramnik only became apparent on the scene when I was already 2000, but I looked at his games a lot. At the time, I was a huge fan when he was an up-and-coming player. He was basically my age, or is my age, so it's kind of natural that this happened. Okay, now he has this f4 f5 stuff. I think I need to stop this somehow. Not super happy about g6, but I think I have to stop f5. There's just no way around it. Even back then, I did quite a bit of opening work because I always liked it. And what I also did, and I think this helped really a lot, was looking at the games that I played quite intensely. I analyzed every game that I played at the time, and that was without computers because we didn't have any. I mean, we had very basic chess computers that were not strong, and therefore you had to do all the work yourself. So he wants to go g4. Okay. First pushing him back, I don't know. Why do I take? I think I'll take. That is unsettlingly weird position. Somehow it's like, no clue what's going on. I still feel like my king is fairly safe on d7. Don't see much happening to him. And h4, I mean, I got some things going on for myself as well. The thing that makes me optimistic here is the bishop on b2, which is essentially dead. Can go to a3, but even that is just an empty diagonal. Therefore, I should be quite substantially better here, I believe. So, h4. And b6. So now that should be end of attack, so to say. Queen, where? I don't see where. So, open this. Open position. Today I visited the largest city nearby, Duisburg, and I was surprised would be strong, but I did not quite expect that they have the Christmas markets completely set up already, and I mean it's November. Not really a huge fan of going on those events, but I was like, huh, what are they doing here? This is probably a German phenomenon. I don't know if they have the same thing anywhere else. Okay, so let's get queens traded. That makes it a bit simpler. I had to Google Kramnik's birthday, okay. I wouldn't have known that. I know a couple of other birthdays by chess players, but Kramnik's, I don't know. The Karpov, Kasparov, and so on, I know, but. Okay, so Atalanta Gaming, thanks for the game. That Wing Gambit is actually, I think, interesting in some way. But a3 is better than d4 on move 3. Now, Schellingfort, yeah, thanks for challenging. I mean, I'm currently not doing the best job in my games, obviously, with my rating being completely hammered. But thanks for playing anyway, because I'm definitely underrated still. Okay. This line, okay. Getting an IQP again, I guess. E takes is kind of normal. Yeah, this I examined in my 2014-2015 book on the Nimzo Bogo. Ugh. Yeah, I mean you can play e takes, which is so boring. So okay, I'll take with the queen just to avoid that totally boring line. Don't think necessarily that this is better. I just wanted something more interesting. The general idea that I'm playing for here is pretty well known. I just don't know if this particular version here is good. Because he might have this break with d5. Wow. Yeah, these are the kind of situations where you wished you just would have played e takes d5 and play that snoozer line where nothing will ever happen. I got a huge initiative and maybe just a huge advantage. Bishop d3, I would need to play b5, which is ugh. Maybe it works, and I mean, works. I mean, maybe it doesn't lose immediately, But it looks close. Taking a bit of time here. Yeah, understandably, because it might be that just one or two good moves will be killing. I still need two moves, Bishop. Okay. Okay. I just wanted squares. Give me squares. Still difficult here. Yeah. Bishop f4 even. I want to go knight d5 next, of course. I don't know if he should go bishop f4. Interesting move. Yeah, I cannot really. Oops. Cannot really say if that's good or not. I mean, I feel like I had a worse position earlier. Yeah, almost for sure I had a queen b1 threatened b5. So the idea was clear to me. I don't think, however, it was so great. Okay. Okay. What now? Knight a4. We cannot move the d pawn. Yeah, no, I'm not taking this, allowing d5. Yeah, by now I can take it. Yeah, I don't believe it. Come on, I take this as well. Bishop b5 or where? Bishop b5, I guess. Okay. Is he just promoting here or what? D7? B7 is hanging. Like something like Rook D8 is going to take B7. I have to play quicker here. The A pawn is quick. I just couldn't figure out if I can stop the pawn anyway, so I felt I'm just okay. Felt I'm just giving it up. He's basically pulling the plug there. This is very drawish. But I can try. And of course, I got more time. Ah, okay, of course. I completely forgot about that. It's a wrong bishop. Wrong bishop. Yeah. Schellingford bungled very badly. Yeah, maybe that was certainly good for white at some point, but of course I was also totally winning. I mean, this position is winning for black somehow here for sure. Or here, I don't know. But you still have to figure it out. And I couldn't. I couldn't. I don't think that that cannot be good for black. I'm 2 pawns up, and the d pawn is not promoting, I think. Anyway, so it was an interesting game. Let's play Doppelangriff. Double attack. At the end, it was a draw, yes. Due to the wrong bishop. Aha. That's an odd move. Nah, I didn't play that well at all. After h6, I don't really have a good move. Ah, boah. Boah, that's terrible. Very badly played. Yeah, this is just nothing at all. Maybe it's equal still, but I have no hopes for an advantage. And usually you can try a little bit in these positions. But this is that was new to me, and my reaction was quite obviously terrible. Okay, yeah, I just got nothing at all. Yeah, the good thing about White's position is it's pretty much without any weaknesses, so you need to yeah, make even more mistakes to be seriously worse. What? Just got a message that I had a winning position after the last move. Why? How can that be a winning position? Was there some trickery that I completely don't understand? I thought it was just the wrong bishop. Or can I force him out of the corner there? I could be. It is just a very little trap, but he cannot take b2 at the end. I can play queen a6, something like that. No. He cannot take b2. I have queen c8, queen c2. Okay. I did not see that. Why did I have a win there? I don't get it. Can I push him out of the corner or something? That deeply irritates me. Ah, okay. So I should have just continued. That was a good bluff then, the draw offer. So I'm getting a pawn back. It might not be enough to save. But yeah, it should be enough. No, it's actually completely enough. I didn't even see that before hangs as well. Then this wasn't such a brilliant idea. By white. Okay, now can I get the knight around and do something? Knight e7, f5, something like that. Doesn't look good. But what can I do? Okay. After this, he wants to go h3, so I have to take it. Objectively, of course, this is a draw, but I'm wondering if I can do something, at least some kind of trickery. But I don't see anything. This is not really helpful, actually. That was a mistake. Knights are tricky. You cannot move the f pawn because then I'm just taking then knight e6, I mean. Okay, it's going to go there. Stopping. Oh, this one. Shoot. Tja. Bad luck. That was a bit of an odd game. Okay, now e7. I have to do this first. Yeah, that was a lucky win, of course. Very lucky win. I'm mostly annoyed by that opening. What did I do there? C6 is terrible, really. In particular, followed up by knight e5. That is really making no sense at all. Don't see anything special though. Okay, I don't want to do any deep analysis. Want to get some more games in. So just like at 71 is my opponent, I'm going to go e4 for a change and see what he does. Okay, against e6, I can also go d4. Taimanov. I have some ideas. That's a weird move, but the idea is to take on c6 and queen g3. Yeah, this ending is somewhat better for white. Rook b8. What was the right move against rook b8 again? I think you take and play bishop f4. Ah, yes, bishop f4 and b3. And now bishop d7, you can take a6. Yes. Yeah, this is quite good for white, this position. c4. Maybe. It is a bit better usually because of the pawn structure, and I already have the h1 rook developed. That can be useful. Okay, now do we push him back there or a bishop d2? He can actually take a4. Not so bad. Okay. Now I think I'm actually threatening to take the pawn and then take a6. Right after. Black queen side is always a little bit shattered, so has to find some good solution there. I'm not sure what black should do. I mean, a5, I just have bishop d2. Okay, this is active. At least it looks active. So just take. I wonder what this is all about. I don't really understand the move, honestly. Where is he going there? Back? No, he's going there. Okay. Now what? Wants to move the knight and probably bishop c5 check. Okay, this is for sure a slight advantage, but maybe it's not the strongest possible continuation. Just getting rid of his nicely positioned c5 knight. And after the capture, bishop d3, yeah, I was attacking this one. Now, if I play bishop d2, he might play rook d4. Is rook h5 something? No, doesn't help him. Doesn't help me, I mean. However, if I play this, and now king e2, how does he prevent bishop c3? Trapping the rook. Don't see it. Now, the silly thing is, there's still a discussion about the Schelling Ford game. I just made a. I should simply not take the draw. I mean, of course, I can. What I can always do is I can just visit on time, but I don't do that because I had like 15 seconds more and I can just move something random and win on time. But I immediately thought, okay, draw, and I took it. But of course, that was not necessary. I could have simply continued and check, oh, wait, is there actually a win or not? Yeah, because I had the time. I was not down on the clock. I had more time than he did. And this is actually the mistake. I should have taken a moment and consider if I really want to make the draw or not. And quite clearly, it was not necessary to take it. Okay, so he's looking at g3 here. So let's go g4. And now bishop d4. That is completely. On f2, then my king will be completely secure. I just need to trade the rook, then it's very simple to win. One rook on e1, one on c1. That should do the trick. Okay. Yeah, that looks like a good defensive move. I can still play this. Now, rook c2. Let's double this. Yeah, the thing is, I don't need to see the winning line in that Schelling Ford game. I just have to continue. And then things will fall into place. I will see it when I just make the moves, I will ultimately see the line that wins. Okay, now this is not so easy. These bishops are pretty good. I'm not quite sure how to win it. It seems like I have to. Oh, bishop c1? No, doesn't work. Now I can just continue because I cannot lose, you know? Not under any reasonable circumstances, at least. And this is why I have to continue. Bishop c5, no. Could have taken the pawn actually. Now we have this bloody time situation again. Oh my god. Got 17 seconds, he's got 20, and he will win the game on time. Heck. Yeah, no draw, of course. How stupid. Yeah, okay, I'm just doing a terrible job here with the time management. It was just, I could take on d5 actually, then he just resigns, but I saw that just a move too late, like here. Where was that? Somewhere I could take on d5. Yeah, here I actually got it pretty well organized. And I cannot take on d5. It's close though. Bishop c5, maybe bishop c5. Yeah, that would probably win. Rook c8, rook d5. Yeah, okay. It's no point in analyzing. The whole game was a one-way street. I was just too slow. Okay, now, who's challenging? Narcissus is not a premium. I should not play him. The Shoulder Doctor, that's a funny name. I'm still not below 2700. If I go below that, I kind of should probably switch to playing marbles or something. And it would be really too low. But okay, it's just too many gifts, yeah. Games like that are just gifts. A Shoulder Doctor does not want to play, it seems. Or maybe he's just currently away fixing shoulders. No, okay. I don't want to wait for a long time. Charles IV. It's a new opponent. Oops. So, d4 again. Yeah, I always have the problem here with the non-increment time control. If I'm playing outside of those banter sessions, I almost never play without increment, because I just feel it's a Stone Age relic that should be abolished altogether. But it's it's difficult in online chess. People just want to have this fun of winning on time, even if the position is completely terrible. And this is why you have problems getting increment games. Now, can I take d5? It's close. Knight d5, e takes, queen takes. Could work. I don't quite think it does, so. Can always go knight a6 at the end. I mean, then maybe knight c6. Huh, maybe I could have taken on d5. Huh, is there really a choice? Why not just take e4 and be done with it? Don't see another move. What else can there possibly be? Yeah, no. Now he will develop the knight and send the prayer upwards. Hope that there's no knight discovery. Maybe that is the case. Yeah. All kinds of city tricks, huh? Knight c5 can come. Okay, let's just make a move. Been a long day. Now I can take a8, but this is not going to be great anyway, so if the queen a8 is always bishop h3 and so on, my light squares are totally weak. Huh. I don't even have a square to go to where d6 is not attacked. Or I mean, sorry, where d6 is covered. That's what I was trying to say. He should probably still save his rook though. Maybe even knight d3 is a playable move. But then I can probably drop back, yeah? Then I'm again covering d6. The queen from a3 is covering d6. Yeah, rook d1 next. And it's probably good for white after all, but really not happy about this game. It's a bit odd. It just drops back. So let me support the pawn. Maybe I could have taken on a7 instead, but I just want to really make sure that I'm not dropping this pawn. Knight e4 maybe. I'm playing this very superficially, like always, just play the first move that comes to mind. Knight e4. Yeah, this time probably I'm helped by the time management. I mean, my position is good, but it looks like he has almost no chance to catch up on the clock. It's just too much. It's almost 3 minutes down. Oh, those pawns are too strong. Yeah, thanks for the game, Charles 4. So let's go for one more game. I was a little bit too late anyway, so okay, the highest rated challenge here is by Sergei Rachmaninov. Sergei Rachmaninov. He beat me last time with some odd game, I remember. When he played a very slowish opening and Yeah, something like that, and then I just killed myself somehow. Yeah, it's the same story. It's like a nothing opening, and then I just this time should not kill myself. That would be helpful. Okay, so I'm going to take. Yeah. My biggest problem with this kind of games is often I just lose interest and then I'm playing something super stupid. I can get the knight to a5, but I don't really think that does much. Or c5 for that matter. Yeah, and not much to say. I mean, there's just nothing going on. I can always blunder it again because I'm kind of sloppy in those kind of positions where nothing happens. I'm going to offer him a draw here, probably won't take it because that's his kind of game. Not much going on. If anybody is better, it's me now and now. Oh, here. What now, buddy? Now he's offering me a draw. Ha! No way. Even got more time. Okay, that's not a bad move. So he wants to crawl up with the king here. But I can enter here, right? Up to here. And now what? Now what? That is an extremely badly placed piece. Yeah, thanks for the game, Sergei Rachmaninoff. A little bit of a revenge for the last loss out of a similarly boring position, but then I played it a lot worse. Okay, guys, we are just in time, midnight. So, yeah, I hope you liked the show. It was a bit different starting time-wise. I hope this becomes a bit more regular with those times. The next show in German language is on Friday at 6 in the evening. So right around, as we say in Germany, Feierabend time. Yeah, so maybe some of you can manage it. I know that there are quite a bit of Germans already here in this show. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll be back next week. And on Friday. Friday and then next week. Okay. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.